everybody. Welcome into another episode of Arsenal Fan Circle. I'm on the road to 50 subs. So if you're new to this channel, if you're just passing by, if you watch on a regular basis but you haven't subscribed, I really would appreciate hitting that subscribe button right down there, the bell notification, and sign up. This stuff is free. As regulars will know that I'm giving you great Arsenal content, great Arsenal insight, stuff all about our club that may not have been mentioned yet on other fan sites, on other YouTube pages. So really, really is valuable stuff. I was one of the first to predict Aaron Ramsey would go to Juventus, and lots of other things. I'll be re-releasing some videos that I did up to 2 months ago, and they're still relevant to this day. So if you're new to the channel, please do subscribe. And with all of that being said, now, are we all tired of the interlull? Are we all tired of starved of no Arsenal content? Well, today's the video is about Arsenal away days and why we should not be worried at all in facing those five away fixtures that we have. Not in any particular order, but we go to Goodison Park, we go to Leicester City, we go to Wolves, which would be a difficult game, we go to Burnley, and we go to Watford. And like I said, not in any particular order, but come on in and see what I have to say about it, and I will tell you why there's no reason to be afraid of these five away games. We will need to be at our best, play reasonably well, but there's no reason why we shouldn't, why we should fear this. So come on in, take a look at what I have to tell you.
Okay, so as you can see here, I have a full league table set out with our home form and our away form. Our home form has been absolutely fantastic. You can see all those three points that we've accumulated over the course of the season. We have to play Crystal Palace, Brighton, and Newcastle. And Newcastle is our game next week, next Monday. So we are on the countdown to Newcastle at home. Newcastle and Brighton, we should take care of those games pretty easily. But as detailed in yesterday's show, I talked about Crystal Palace and how they are a dangerous team away from home. So when Crystal Palace come to the Emirates, that will be a dangerous game for us that we need to get. But we need to take all 3 points. And all of these three games are mid to low table teams. So we're going to play Newcastle, Crystal Palace and Brighton. But you can see our home form is absolutely superb. We picked up 3 points against all of the bottom teams and right up until Wolves, when we played them a tricky one at home. But you can even see that we have beaten Chelsea at home, we've beaten Manchester United, we've beaten Tottenham, and we drew with Liverpool. So going on that basis, we should get 3 points in each of those three home games. But this, and you can see, we have at home, we've won 13 games, drawn 2, and lost only 1 versus Manchester City, amassing 41 points. Now, we need to look at the away form here. Our away days, out of 14 games, we've won 5, we've drawn 4, and we've lost 5, giving us 19 points so far. Now, to finish off the season, we have 5 more games. I've drawn a line underneath Everton for our away performances. Everything below that green line at Everton, we have won most of those games, and that's the highest that we have won away from home was versus Bournemouth and Newcastle. So that's the danger line that everyone's talking about, that we haven't actually gotten 3 points away from home in any of the top 11 as they stand right now. But I will get back to that in a second. Whereas you can see below 11th, 12th down to 20, we've won all 5. We've won 5 of those games, drawn at Crystal Palace and Brighton, which we really should have won both of those games. And of course, we had a very, very bad day at Southampton, which we all know about. We have to play Burnley, probably the last game of the season. I'm hoping we've wrapped everything up by then. But let's take the top half of the table. And this is my reason for this video, is to explain why we should not be afraid to go away from home. Let's take that Tottenham result away from home. We all know we should have won that game, but for a refereeing decision on the offside and a subsequent foul by Mustafi, we would have won that game, irrespective of the penalty at the end of the game. Manchester United away from home, that was a draw, a 2-2 draw. That came down to our concentration levels at the back, conceding goals right after we scored them on both occasions. Everyone knows that Chelsea away from home, that was our first away game, and we really should have won. We played very, very well in the second game of the season at Stamford Bridge and should have turned that zero into at least a 1 or 3 points. West Ham was just an off day. Now, let's focus on these four away games: Wolverhampton, Watford, Leicester City and Everton. Wolverhampton and Watford are involved in the FA Cup. I believe if we catch them on good days on it for us, we can get 4 points out of those games. I think they will be distracted by their FA Cup exploits, and we'll be able to get a reasonable amount of points from there. And then we go to Everton and Leicester City, and they are also winnable games for us. So we need to get 3 points, that's for sure, away from home, in a higher place than Bournemouth, and those wins will come versus Wolverhampton Wanderers or Watford or Leicester City or Everton. I think we can beat Burnley also away from home, and out of these five away days, Burnley, Everton, Leicester City, Wolverhampton Wanderers and Watford, I think we can get by with 10 points there. So that would be 3 wins and 1 draw and 1 defeat. And we have afforded ourselves this luxury now because we played so well against Manchester United. Also, a Crystal Palace game at home will be difficult. But I believe our away day finishing could read something like 9-5-6. So that would be 4 wins, 1 draw and 1 loss, or rather 3 wins. So it would be 8-4-6, 8-5-6. 8 wins, 5 draws and 6 defeats, which would still be a very, very marked improvement on what we had in the last 2 seasons. But this is what I am saying. This is why I'm saying we should not have anything to worry about. In away days, we can face these with confidence.
So as you can see, I've outlined why we should not be afraid to go away from home and win 3 out of those 5 games. Maybe draw another one and lose. We can lose one of them because we have done so well in the last 2 games versus Tottenham and Manchester United especially, that we can afford ourselves a minor slip up in the league. I'm charting 78 points or 79 points as a finishing total for the season, and if you look at 79 points versus 63 points from last season, that is an outstanding difference. It will be an extra 25% approximately improvement in terms of points gained per season for Unai Emery and the lads, and who could say that would not be a bad season. Also, we are going to go deep into the Europa League. Let's see how we get on against Napoli, but that's for another day. I hope you've all enjoyed this video, and please, please, please leave a comment down there if you liked this video that I put together. We are all starved of Arsenal content, and this is the beginning of a big week for Arsenal. Next Monday, we will take on Newcastle, where we start this whole process at home. Until next time, peace.